The Philippines' oldest conglomerate forges ahead with its digital pivot, with former Ayala Corporation CEO Jaime Zobel De Ayala even launching his own online show with BPI. How are the next generation Zobels taking this digital transformation further? Joining us now is Mariana Zobel De Ayala, the deputy head of marketing for BPI. Good morning, Mariana.
Good morning, Warren. Thanks so much for having us.
Thank you so much for coming on the show. You know, I was able to watch the first show of Jaza's series. It's great. It's well produced. And he looks like he's having a lot of fun. I will have to ask, though, in terms of that production, who's the boss? Is it him or are you calling the shots?
Well, I hope you enjoyed it, Warren. You know, it was interesting because we realized that there was actually this very unique entrepreneurial spirit that connected so many of our BPI clients. And we see After Six as really a celebration of that. It's a chance to really peek behind the curtain and better understand what inspires, you know, some of these most sought after change makers, and a chance to learn about their interests. And as an institution for us as BPI, it's also a chance for us to strengthen that relationship with our clients and build a like-minded community, enabling Filipino trailblazers and entrepreneurs as agents of change. I guess that's how we see them, towards building a better Philippines.
Yeah, absolutely. And it shows you that you value, you know, social media and online media very much. So tell us a bit about the communication strategy behind this and putting one of your most recognizable faces, Jaza, at the helm.
Yeah, well, two things really, Warren. After Six is really a wink to what's supposed to be after standard office hours. And we thought it's a chance, it's the right environment to get to know some of our country's change makers in a more relaxed setting and understand what inspires them, and also how, in many cases, BPI has enabled them to drive change in our country. In the case of our chairman, Jaza, he has a great relationship with, you know, a number of individuals and enjoys connecting with people, from our employees to our clients and even others. And we thought he would bring out the right context to better understand the background of these change makers and even bring out parts of them that we wouldn't normally see and get to know.
Yeah, and it's actually very enjoyable, the format and the editing. Well done. But tell us a bit about how you value the online media right now, and where do you think that's headed? Obviously, you put some serious thought into this, and it's really how a lot of the other media companies are pivoting. Obviously, ABS-CBN right now, we are an online broadcast company. How important is it to create a presence, especially for a company like a BPI, where apparently you guys want to take control of your own media presence with this show?
No, absolutely. I think especially now it goes without saying, Warren, that it's really our main channel of in our ability to connect with our clients. So it's extremely important for us. And we continue to, you know, test and reinvent the way that we connect with our clients, and the kind of trend jacking that we did with what was inspired by the Bay Alonso post was a chance to test and get to know maybe a younger community set.
Yeah, absolutely. We took note of that as well. Quite a funny take. Talking about BPI, though, moving forward, you've already had some success in your digital pivot. But where do you see yourselves now at this point, especially with the Delta variant arriving here in the Philippines and creating complications across the economy? Again, putting into doubt the reopening of the economy. How do you feel about your digital pivot right now? And do you think it's going to be really the only way forward regarding that? And of course, tell us a bit about what you plan to do with your brick and mortar.
Yeah, well, so I think in terms of the market as a whole, we remain cautious, especially given the news of the Delta variant and awaiting the outcomes of the vaccine rollout, you know, how consumers react, how safe they feel. But the environment has definitely given us a chance to prioritize and double down on our digital platforms. As you probably know, Warren, we're starting to realize the benefits of what's been many years of investing in the digital space. But I'd say that I think BPI has a unique opportunity to be the undisputed leader in digital banking. We have significant physical presence with our branches and ATMs that are strategically located around the country. And that, combined with our digital platform, puts us really in the best position to transition Filipinos from what's a cash-dominant society to what we think will be an inclusive digital and convenience first lifestyle. So obviously the pandemic has accelerated digital banking among Filipinos. And I think most would agree that once you've experienced the convenience of digital banking, there's really no turning back. But we do feel that in this transition from this cash first society, we are in the best position to support the Filipino towards this digital future.
Yeah, absolutely. I myself do not want to experience waiting in line again at a bank for anything at this point. But talk about some of the trends that you've noticed with your clientele. This pandemic, it has a lot of people. We've interviewed a lot of people on the ground. They've been talking now about really beefing up their savings. And especially now with the Delta variant arriving, we talked to some people on the ground just yesterday, and they're just worried about another lockdown and then about losing their income. And they've been trying to beef up their savings. Have you seen an increase in savings at this point in terms of your clientele?
Absolutely. I think we've noticed a take up for some of our more what's, I guess, known to the public as some of our safer products in kind of our deposit space, money markets, etc. And I think the benefit is that we offer a wide range of products in that sense. So if you know, the market is feeling a little more cautious and the consumers are feeling a bit more anxious about the uncertainty ahead of them, there's kind of a range of options that we can offer depending on your risk appetite or your outlook.
Yeah, absolutely. That's certainly something that the BSP has been pushing forward with as well in terms of financial inclusion. Talk a bit about that. How have you been working to make your products more available to a wider audience? A lot of the other digital banks, they've been offering actually some really high interest savings products or deposit products. What does BPI plan on that front?
Ayala and BPI really has kind of a history of continuous reinvention through the years. What's interesting about this new era of digitalization is actually that it enables our goals of financial inclusion, customer centricity, and sustainability. As I've said, you know, digitalization is quite exciting because of the potential it brings for inclusivity, and the pandemic has really driven that and sped that up for us. Even as we look forward to kind of a different or a COVID different future, we think that digitalization has put the groundwork necessary to be able to broaden our market and broaden the inclusion, especially since majority, 70% of adult Filipinos don't have access to bank accounts today. So we look forward to the better, to greater take up to be able to better serve them. And we think that the way forward is really digitally, that we can offer the value and service needed in a digital front. And similarly, one can never be too customer centric, and every day is a chance to level up in that front. So we now have the benefit of best in class analytics brought forward by digital usage, which allows us to really tailor to customer needs and offer very personalized solutions. All of this, of course, adds to our goals of kind of sustainability and in support of the broader sustainable development goals.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And you said a mouthful. I guess the other digital banks coming in should be prepared for competition from you guys. What can you say about that, though? It's really a growing space right now, although the BSP is trying to limit the number of digital bank licenses it's giving out. Well, how do you view that market right now and your competitors?
You know, competition is good. Is good for the consumer. And as a consumer-centric company, we welcome that because I think it's a chance to constantly reflect on what is the best offering for the consumer need at hand. So we definitely welcome that. But I will say that I think we're uniquely positioned as a bank, and I think what differentiates us to the traditional kind of fintechs or the newer entrants in the market is we offer a broader suite of products, really, for every life stage. So as mentioned, you know, depending on the outlook or the risk appetite of the consumer, we're able to offer according to those needs. And beyond that, we have a wide suite of investment products, of loan products, both at the retail loan side and also at the personal loan and credit card side as well. And I think the uniqueness of that expanse of solutions allows us to offer something for every life stage.
Okay, final question before I let you go. I was wondering, what else do you have planned for Jaza? Are you going to make him work hard for his money after six? What else do you have?
No, absolutely. Well, actually, next month is our 170th anniversary or birthday of BPI. So we invite you, Warren, and the entire community to stay tuned because we look forward to some exciting updates about how we're looking to reinvent financial services for Filipinos.
All right. Thank you so much for your time this morning. Mariana Zobel De Ayala, Deputy Head of Marketing for BPI.
Thank you, Warren.